and the best food is pretty.
Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome to Let's Play King's Quest. An episodic release, believe it or not. Seems to be inspired by the Telltale games. Same with the autosave feature. Do not turn the system on and off. This is a blind Let's Play. I'm a big fan of the original games, and I've played, well, the remakes of 1, 2, and 3 on this channel by AGD Interactive. Awesome. I always planned to play the fourth one, but I've heard there's a remake of or two of that one in the works, so I've just been kind of like holding out, and now we have this. I mean, I guess I don't know much about it. I know Sierra is involved somehow, but I'm not sure if Activision owns Sierra. I don't know, maybe you guys have an idea. This is a relatively quiet game, so I have my mic. I have a powerful mic, but my mic's at 50% and the sound is all the way up. As you can see, I have subtitles on. This doesn't go anymore. There's no ultra full screen, of course, V-Sync. This is my resolution. I'll just go apply, because I think I changed something. As usual, I've played through like the first about 20 minutes of this, the first sequence, some kind of arcade style, you know, thing they got going on. The QuickTime events are a little harder, but even though you got washed, you can still use the arrow keys, just like in the Telltale games. Games of the space bar is use interact. You can also use interact with the, that would be the left mouse button. I'm strange. I use the button. I use the mouse upside down, inverted, even though I don't use invert. Now this is weird. You've got A-Z-R-T-Y. Is that a kind of keyboard? But it just changes the W and A, so whoever has a keyboard like that, I guess it's, you know, gotta be from European or something like that, right? Gameplay, controller vibration. I'm not using a controller, so I turn that off. I mean, wouldn't make a difference. Mouse sensitivity seems fine to me. And I don't need to invert Y. Credits belong after the game, I feel. And that's it. So, I like to show people what I'm playing on, you know, what I have the graphics set at. The ironic thing is I just installed last night the GTX 970, the for the win from EVGA, which you can overclock, and I'm playing a game like this, you know, but I'm gonna get up to the high intensity game soon enough, believe me. Chapters and play achievements, I don't have any yet. Right, continue, because I played up to a certain point. But I do not want to continue. This is the only way I know to start over. Delete your save. So it said a minute, so because I kept going in and changing the audio settings, trying to figure out what worked. You know. So I like my voice to be always slightly louder than the narrator. So now we can begin. The game starts very unceremoniously. Just kind of drops you down here. Lets you know There's no mouse look or anything like that? I mean, sometimes when you look at items or locations, there's a mouse look. When you have to select something, like target something, there's a mouse look. Otherwise, that's it. I'm moving the mouse. That's it. This is your inventory, which you use by hitting tab, as you can see. And we have nothing in there right now. So, you use the arrow keys to move back and forth. Or forward and back. Forgot. Sorry. Wanted to get a look at him. Sir Graham. Soon to become King Graham. This is a retelling of the first game, sort of. Very differently embellished in different ways. So you can hit spacebar, or you can hit, as I'm using, the... Actually, it's the left mouse button. As you can see, you could hit S or arrow key. So after we get past this first sequence, we're going to be completely blind, guys. Just so you know. I just wanted to get a feel for the game and the mechanics. That and do a test of the recording as well.
I have not been back there in years, but it was the last place left to look. Those lost wishes weren't the treasure I was after.
I would have gathered them up anyway, though. So the first thing I thought when coming down here is, what the hell is a mattress doing down here?
It was not exactly as I remembered it, but it wasn't all that different either.
I didn't have to do anything there, he automatically jumped. What's with the frame rate?
Two odd contraptions guarded the lost treasure. I would have to turn one and see what happened.
It reminds me of Dumbledore. Now this is the bad one. He barely touched it.
And that's what would have happened if I turned the left switch. But since I am here telling this story, you already know that I pulled the right one.
I just wanted to show that. Of course, the first time I did try the left switch, and that happened. And another mattress. I have a top-notch graphics card, and I'm getting frame rate hits. I'm not...
Pockets, valves, butter churns, and beds were jammed in every nook and cranny of that cave. It all seems so familiar.
Man, so familiar. And yeah, you wonder, what the hell is with all the beds? Still don't have anything. At some point we get something.
Even though the bed was very comfortable, this was no time to hide under the covers.
I actually think it's hilarious the way he throws the blanket up like that.
Wait. Hold on, Grandpa. I don't remember this part of the story. beds hanging from stalactites?
We'll get there, Gwendolyn. Don't worry. No detail in this story will be overlooked. Now, where was I? Ah, yes. As I treaded through the river of rumbling trundles, I feared I knew the source of that deafening wind.
Oh, now that goes back.
Nestled beneath a slumbering pile of teeth and claws was...
Fabled Mirror!
Oh, so you remember this part of the story.
Well, dragons are my favorite.
You want to tell this part?
Yes. King Edward sent me, the greatest knight in all of Daventry, on a quest to return his stolen mirror. A gigantic, hulking beast of a dragon was the last thing in my way to...
my way to add a shinier hat to my collection.
Gonna restart the recording now and then because what's with the frame rate hits, Batman? And that will cause audio video desync if I let that go on too long without correcting it. Now the funny thing is you go, well, can't even point. You go that way. It talks about this missing handle. Even though you've never been here to see the rest of the handle.
I tried to turn that crazy contraption, but it was missing a handle. Someone tampered with it, creating some silly conundrum.
Conundrum. Now the funny thing is, I bypassed that. I don't think I even saw that, and I ran over here first. He's talking about a handle. I'm like, what handle? You see what I mean? Pretend we didn't go there, you know, so. Can't do anything there. Oh, there's another bed.
As I was saying, this was no time to take a nap.
But I love naps. You look at this stuff first.
Volumes of old books. With foreboding titles clutter the shelves of that strange bedroom. How to Tame a Dragon. Breaking the Spirit of Hideous Beasts. Amateur Spells to Impress Your Friends With. No books about recovering missing handles, though.
So reminds me of Dumbledore. See, now we can actually... We have mouse luck, but only in this area. Strange. Not what I'm used to.
So, the missing handle was booby-trapped? What did you do?
Well, I used my cleverness to outsmart the trap.
See, so you're like, well, how do we know it was a handle?
I used my cleverness to hide.
This is when these beds come in handy. Why the place is full of beds, I don't know. Maybe because he's... It's like a dream to him? I don't know. I don't know what happens. I guess you die if you don't go into bed.
Luckily, that half-blinded beast never noticed me in bed.
A dragon's eye must be really hard to pierce with an arrow. At archery lessons, I can barely hit a hay bale.
It is indeed a feat only for skilled archers.
Now I can go back. Now it makes sense.
I tried to turn that crazy contraption, but it was missing a handle. Someone tampered with it, creating some silly conundrum.
What did you use to fix the broken switch?
this. Forgot I was supposed to do that first in inventory. Now, the first thing I thought is, isn't the dragon down there where all those rocks fell? That doesn't wake him up, but the bell does.
The dragon's chains were coiled around a gigantic switch mounted to the
cave
wall. This cave seemed to be filled with failed adventures. After he briefly basked in the sun, the narcoleptic dragon went back to snoring.
I'd probably sleep all day too, if Amira was my only friend.
I'm sorry about this, guys. I don't understand. Alright, so you've got little crevices you can hide along. That's unavoidable. Strange looking mouth, huh? Well, it's kind of hard to see around his cape sometimes. In fact, he stopped for a sec. I think we could have crunched on those, but I think the game didn't let us. Just in case, I'm going to assume that we have to be careful and not step on these. King Graham, professional bed hider, inner, whatever.
Whoever designed this trap thought they were pretty clever, but I would probably find a way to hit that unreachable switch.
Yep, there it is. You know, it shouldn't show us inventory unless we have something in it, that's what I think, but what do I know? Come on, pry off those cold, dead fingers. Never seen so many mattresses in my life. Maybe he started off as a mattress salesman.
The mirror called out to me.
I remember what to do.
A ridiculous feeding contraption was cobbled together to keep the beast and probably its owner alive.
Oh yeah, and then you pull this bell. The thing is, what kind of meat? Like, what meat? What kind of creature does meat come from? That was the owner. He's not alive anymore. So the dragon might have eventually died? Not sure why it goes over there, but we can make that work for us. Looks a lot farther away than when we were up here. Ta-da! I see how heavy that is when he picks it up. He tosses in his cape. Oh my god, and I'm playing with...
Let me guess, you escaped with only a flesh wound.
Down all this crap. More mattresses. They don't give you a lot of time with these quick time events. I did it. We're not out yet, though. I failed so many times in the first time through this. It seems so peaceful, doesn't it? Not anymore. I'm like a pro at this now. Run, 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 run.
the magic mirror safely in my possession, I dreamt of a Daventry I would be rewarded with, and the kingdom it could become. I had three choices in front of me. Any would clear my path to safety, and all would have rippling consequences.
Now, I didn't even know what I was doing when I hit this. But I figured you have a choice of killing it or hitting that, which sets it free. And then I was like, oh, crap, and, maybe it's thankful.
My hands were shaking and my arms could barely grip the rope, but with the last of my strength, I climbed out of the well and headed back to the castle. Ever since the magic mirror returned, its reflections have warned the kingdom of danger, kept our family safe, and it has exposed many troublesome crumbs tangled in my beard.
Yeah. King Edward was so proud that you returned his lost treasure that he made you king. Everyone knows that part. Now, can we get back to that dragon?
Gwendolyn! There's so much more to my stories than dragons. I hope this old cap will be remembered for far more than the action tattered across its brim. Sewn into the seams are many hidden adventures. All right, let's get back to the dragon.
Tell me everything. Like, why did you set the dragon free, even though he was trying to eat you?
I set him free because, well, over the years I realized that the dragon was not the despicable, hideous beast Daventry had made him out to be. He was just a caged animal that was never shown any kindness. On that day, I forgave the dragon for his atrocious past.
A wise choice.
You have such a bizarre way of making friends, Grandpa. I guess I do, too. I'm known as Gwendolyn the Popular back home. But only to my stuffed bunnies.
I've always found it best to pursue friends where I can, though they don't always feel the same about me.
All right, you two. Mm-hmm. Grandpa needs to rest. Gwendolyn, it's way past your bedtime.
Sleep well, Grandpa. I'll be back first thing in the morning.
I don't need rest. I'm as spry as I've ever been. Though I wouldn't mind a slice of magic fruit.
Okay, guys. Gonna sign off here. I want to thank you for watching. I am going to try to iron out whatever's going on with the frame rate hit we're getting at the beginning of each new scene. Hasn't happened in these scenes so far with older Graham. Sure, I'll appreciate be calling him Older Graham and not Old Graham, because he's still spry, you know. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.